Mr. O'Hara. Doctor, glad to be with you. Thank you for the good work. When the effort started, when we mobilized to combat the virus, we depended heavily on our hospitals because they were set up and ready to go. And as the vaccine began flowing into our state, we're getting our pro rata share based on population of 18 year olds and above. And it's been coming in at about 800 and total. Our allocation originally was 822,000. Now it's coming in at about 120,000 doses of both vaccines, Pfizer and Moderna, a week. But we got off to a slow start. And after meeting with the hospitals, encouraging, discovering where the bottlenecks were, I can say that many of our hospitals are performing at maximum capacity, and Prisma is certainly in that category. Prisma has been a leader. Prisma has numerous hospitals around our state, and the fact that they are administering what is at least their 100,000th dose is good news for South Carolina. Now, many of these doses, as Mr. O'Hara mentioned, are not in the hospitals. The hospitals have the freezers that go down to 158 degrees below zero, as you know. A lot of places don't have such freezers as that to keep the vaccine at its proper temperatures. That's why Moderna is going out into a lot of the other areas, including the rural areas. But we now have about 300 or so, closing in on 300 pharmacies that have the vaccine and should be administering that vaccine as quickly as the hospitals are administering the vaccine. But the pharmacies got a later start, because Moderna was a little later getting here than Pfizer was, the Pfizer vaccine. But it is now time for the pharmacies to do the same thing that the hospitals have done, and that is kick it into gear and get every one of those vaccines in the arms of a South Carolinian before their next shipment comes in. We want them to run out, give those shots as quickly as they can, use the maximum capacity, schedule the second doses as Prisma has done. When they give the first dose, they schedule the time and place for the second dose, the same place. So we want the pharmacies and those out in the more rural areas to do the same things that our hospitals are doing now. And when we get everyone operating at maximum capacity, that will be good news for the people of South Carolina. You may know just in the last week that the allocations have increased. That is, the production by Pfizer and Moderna have increased 16% over what was coming before. So we're getting about 19,000 more doses a week this week than we got the week before. We're hoping to expand that. We are told that by March we should have even more coming in. So it is vitally important now for all of our sites and those that we will be setting up to be operating at maximum capacity, maximum speed. The hospitals, most of them, not all, but most, have done a good job of getting on track. And Prisma is certainly in that top category. But we got to get our pharmacies moving and the rural health centers, because that's where a lot of people are. That is the rest of the playing field, and we've got to get everybody out there working. So this is a great moment. This is quite a celebration. It is a little rainy and it's cold, but I think all South Carolinians are warm and happy to see the National Guard, the University of South Carolina, Prisma, and volunteers all working together to see that we're keeping our people safe and happy for a wonderful prosperity. And thank you, and congratulations to Prisma.
Thank you.